Assalamu alaikum everyone. Jazakumullah khairah to the organizers and to all of you for attending and listening to me. I'm wary of the time, so if I'm a bit rushed, apologies, but I'm just trying to cover everything. So just to give you a bit of a background, who I am. So my name's Nabil Vora. I was born in East London and I lived most of my life there. I lived in West London for a short time as well in other places. Alhamdulillah, I did well in school and in college, and I got good grades. And for one reason or another, I decided to pursue engineering. So I went to University College London, which alhamdulillah is a very good university, and I studied chemical engineering there with Ustad Ibrahim. And I graduated back in 2013, and then I went straight into working for an engineering company. So I worked for a nuclear engineering company, and I've been with them ever since I graduated. So I studied chemical engineering, and the first few years of the company, I worked in process engineering, which is the same thing as chemical engineering. And then after about 3 years, I kind of transitioned and I moved into safety engineering. And that's where I currently work at the moment. So just to take a step back and talk about what is engineering. So just to give a kind of very high level definition of what engineering is all about the kind of application of science and mathematics to solve problems. So that's kind of what it is in a nutshell. And engineers are kind of concerned with how things work and the practical applications of, you know, of these things. And there are many different disciplines within engineering, different types of engineering. So there's mechanical engineering, chemical engineering, which I did, electrical engineering, electronic engineering, computer engineering. It's quite varied. So don't think that, you know, if it's engineering, it's kind of maths and physics and, you know, there's not too much difference to that. There is definitely kind of a solid core to it, which is maths and physics based for most of the engineering disciplines. But then beyond that, there is kind of each discipline has its own different take and different flavor. So depending on kind of what you're more interested in, you can decide whether you want to go down chemical engineering or electrical engineering, etc. And also engineering, it kind of covers and permeates a lot of different fields and industries. So you could be working in food and beverage, you could be working in the pharmaceutical industry, in energy. There's a wide range of industries that you could find yourself working in. So why do engineering? I mean, thing is, if you're a person who likes numbers, you know, you like problem solving, you like science, I think engineering is a very kind of natural choice to make in terms of the career that you want to pursue. If I really had to kind of summarize it all in one word, or kind of, you know, what type of person you need to be if you wanted to become an engineer, it would be that you need to be a problem solver, or you need to enjoy solving problems. Maybe you're working on a calculation, maybe you're working on a report, but kind of what it all will kind of boil down to is that trying to solve a problem or trying to create a solution. Another reasons as to why you may want to do engineering. So like I said, you know, if you like problem solving, if you like numbers, also the opportunities that engineering can present, you know, you can find yourself working in many different environments. You might be working in the office one day, the rest of the week you're working on site, you're working on a big power station, or you're out in the sea working on an oil rig. So if you like kind of working in those different types of environments, you like being a bit hands-on, that those opportunities are there for you as well. And another reason to do it, in terms of kind of the salary that is available if you choose to pursue engineering. In general, engineering does provide a good kind of comfortable salary. I know you get kind of lots of lists produced every year, kind of what the average salary is for X, Y, Z, you know, profession. I wouldn't put too much kind of emphasis on those, because in my experience I've not always found them to be totally accurate. But nonetheless, despite, you know, whatever engineering field you want to go down, I will say that, you know, you can expect, you know, inshallah, to have a good comfortable salary, if not a very good salary. And also, engineering in general is a very kind of secure industry. Obviously, you know, different industries might have different kind of peaks and troughs, or, you know, good times and bad times. But if you're an engineer and you have like a kind of good solid engineering background, you know, you should be able to move between these industries, and you should, you know, inshallah, always be able to find work. In terms of the requirements and skills required to pursue engineering, so number one has to be kind of mathematics. You know, you've got to be kind of, you know, good with numbers and comfortable with numbers. And then, you know, when you say science, science. I mean, specifically, I would say physics. Physics is very important in terms of kind of what you'd be doing day to day as an engineer, and especially it kind of permeates all these different disciplines: mechanical, chemical. I mean, if for example, if you were to do like something involved with software engineering, hardware engineering, then I'm not too sure. I can't speak on their behalf, but I don't think physics would be as much a requirement there. But definitely for most engineering disciplines, you know, you definitely need mathematics, and physics is a good one to have. And then beyond that, it's just about kind of which field you want to go into. If you want to go into chemical engineering, then you take chemistry as well. Then, you know, you'd have an interest in chemistry. You know, if you want to do something computer-based, and you would take ICT or IT or whatever. And then, yeah, those are kind of the subjects that you need to take. And in terms of kind of the general skills, then, like I said before, problem solving, you know, being challenged. You've got to be good with working with computers in general, because a lot of engineering nowadays is computer-based, you know, producing calculations and reports. But it can also be very hands-on, and you can be on site and actually doing kind of hands-on engineering. And then there are other kind of soft skills that you need, which you need in most, you know, professions, like, you know, team working, being able to work independently, etc. What to expect? So, you know, you can expect, like I said, a good salary with engineering. I think it can be quite varied. You know, so you can earn a lot of money, can do very well. Or at the very least, you should be earning a comfortable money. And money isn't the be all and end all, by all means. I mean, once you start working, I think you quickly realize that money, salary isn't the main thing. But nonetheless, it is important. And with engineering, inshallah, you should have a comfortable salary. And like I said, job security, you know, that's very important. And in general, engineering is quite a secure field and profession to work in. What else to expect? I mean, it's difficult to say, because you could be working for a big company, you could be working for a small company, and it can be quite a different experience. You could be working on site, you could be working in the office, you could be doing a mixture of both, you could choose to work abroad. So inshallah, if we get chance, and maybe in the question and answer, I can go into more detail. But the point is that you can expect a good comfortable salary, and good job security, a good work-life balance, and there are a lot of different industries that you could potentially be working in. My typical working day or week, so again, it's quite varied, but I'll have meetings to attend, I'll have calculations to produce, reports to produce. A lot of my meetings will be kind of within my own team, my own discipline, other safety engineers, but then occasionally, maybe, you know, not as frequently, I'd have to interface and have meetings with other types of engineers, and that's where we kind of bring things together. Visiting site and going on site, obviously things have changed a lot now since COVID has happened, and there will be some long-term changes as well. Maybe we'll be working from home a lot more, but nonetheless, you know, calculations, reports, working independently most of the time when you're doing these things, but then also working in teams and interacting with others are things that you can expect to be doing on a typical day or a typical week. Salary expectations, I already said that, you know, you can expect a good salary. I think engineering generally is kind of at the higher end of starting salaries. I would suggest looking at actual engineering companies and see what their starting salaries are to get a better idea, rather than kind of the generic lists that are produced. And I'd also say that generally speaking, engineering does provide a good work-life balance. Obviously, there are peaks and troughs, and it can differ between different companies and industries. But in general, I think with engineering, a lot of the time you will find that your work is your work, and your home life is your home life. So me personally, I work my hours at work, and alhamdulillah, I never have to worry about work outside of that. And my own life is for me and my family, and my own hobbies and interests that I pursue. And that's very important. You know, I mean, I would take kind of that work-life balance over a higher salary in certain ways. So that's having that good work-life balance is very, very important. And also, it's the other benefit is that in general, you know, engineering does give you a source of halal income, you know, which is also something that we strive for and is reassuring for us. So in summary, engineering is a good halal industry to be involved in. Do good with numbers, problem solving. It's something worth considering if you like science as well. Lots of different types of engineering for you to think about, and different industries that you could be working in. And lots of Muslims do engineering as well. So, you know, you shouldn't be, you know, you should have company, and you shouldn't be alone. And like I said, if there are any questions, please feel free to ask in the question and answer session. And barakallahu feekum for inviting me today. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Jazakallah khair. You can tell Nabil is an engineer. He stuck the time exactly. If I can just mention one more thing before we move on to our next speaker. In terms of engineering, I really want to highlight this point what Nabil mentioned, in that don't think of an engineer as a person who puts on a hard hat and goes off dressed in overalls and goes off somewhere far away. I've graduated from engineering. I've been working for nearly 10 years now. my job is I go to the office like everyone else, shirt and trousers, going to the city, going to London Wall, going to Liverpool Street, work in an office, come back home, and that's it. So don't think in your head that that's the engineer. No, an engineer, he can be the one in a hard hat and in overalls, or he can be the one working in an office. He gets to choose which career he goes to, but and both of them can be counted as engineering.